letting me talk on this. At the outset, I would like to congratulate our Honorable Finance Minister for having put all her energy. She has led very dynamically with a lot of enthusiasm to put the country's economy back on a revival trajectory. And I would also point out that a quarter-on-quarter GDP growth of 8.4% was reported on constant prices. And further, for the first half of this financial year, a GDP growth of 13.7% was reported on the corresponding period of the previous year. And even the GST collections have substantially increased year on year. I respect what the senior Dada has spoke, but I think the rise in inflation and the rise in GST collections, there's a lot of difference. GST collections have definitely increased, and we should definitely appreciate the Honorable Finance Minister, because if something goes wrong, definitely we point out things at her. When something is right, I think she needs to get the credit. This is in the national perspective. But I would like to come, I would like to talk about my state's issue, sir. Before I go into that, I would like to recall that both the NDA and UPA came together and split our state. State bifurcation was thrust on our state, even though we didn't want the bifurcation, people of Andhra didn't want. But that's a old story, sir. But during bifurcation, two things were promised to us, sir. We call the parliament temple of democracy. Every word has to be respected here. The previous honorable ex-Prime Minister Manmohan ji and the current honorable Prime Minister Sri Modi ji, both of them promised various things, sir. And I think this is one of the few issues where NDA, UPA have come together and without any dispute have they passed this act and they have split the state. So I would like to recall, sir, that special category status was promised to us, sir. I will tell you why it was promised also, sir. Sir, on the day of when the state was split, if you see the state's per capita, state's own revenues, for Telangana it was 15,454 rupees. And for Andhra Pradesh, it was 8,979 rupees, sir. There's a huge difference. And we had unviable finances. And special category status was promised, sir, both in the house and off the house, sir. So we demand the government should keep up its word, because we are really, really worried about the future of our state. We were given unviable finances. We don't have a way out, sir. And even AP Reorganization Act, various promises were made in the AP Reorganization Act. And the tenure of the AP Reorganization Act is for 10 years, and it's almost 8 years which have passed now. There's just 2 years left. There are various promises which have to be fulfilled, sir. Before I go into the details of the AP Reorganization Act things, I would like to tell a story, sir, I mean, if with your kind permission. So once, like, just to point out the attitude, sir, once there was a great king who wanted to help a state, sir. So he called all his wise men and he said, work out something and you help that state. So the king, once he told this wise men, the wise men sat together. They said, okay, we will give you a painting of a majestic tiger so that you will overcome all your troubles and things. It will be a very valuable asset, sir. So the wise men sat and they said, okay, the tail should not be so long, make it a little bit short. And they said, one other wise man said, so many stripes are not there in the, most of the tigers, so reduce the stripes. And one more person said, make the ear short. And one more wise man said, the paws are big, make them small. And finally, the people were so many, were anticipating what was there, and there was a big unveiling ceremony. Finally, it was unveiled, they found a cat, sir. It was not a tiger, it was a cat. I just want to tell this story because I want to point out the attitude, sir. All the promises made in the AP Reorganization Act, they're finding one way or the other, sir. There were some irresponsible answers, which I don't want to mention the name. They were saying the tenure of AP Reorganization Act is for 10 years, and it's only 8 years passed. Still, we have 2 years to fulfill, sir. What is this sort of answer, sir? We don't accept this sort of answers. Even Polavaram project, they find n number of reasons saying a lot of funds are blocked. Even the revenue deficit gap, there have been a lot of issues which have been pointed out and not fulfilled. Even Petro Corridor, now we have been asked to pay viability gap with thousands of crores upfront for setting up the Petro Corridor. Even the backward districts grant, which was promised to us, which is, it is very meager, sir. We were promised in the lines of Bundelkhand package or anything. We don't understand why we are being treated like this, why Andhra Pradesh is being treated in this most pathetic way. So we request, sir, we request the government, we request the Honorable Minister, we request the Council of Ministers, even the Honorable Prime Minister, to keep up what they have promised, sir. It's not just the NDA, even the UPA, sir. I want the attention of the House, because both of them promised, both of them split our state, but now things are happening. Now we are not in a very good situation. So we want the government to help us out in this situation, sir. I would like to point out about the Polavaram project, sir. The Polavaram project was started by late Honorable Chief Minister, Vice Rajasekhar. Almost, if you see, like 44 people died, even a SDRF constable died, and there were like 1400 villages and almost 196 mandals which got affected, and there's huge damage which has happened. So I request, through yourself, I request the government to release an amount of at least 1,000 crores as interim relief, and also depute inter-ministerial central team to assess the damage and losses caused by the heavy rains. So they were unprecedented rains, sir, not even like, I think in the last 200 years, these were the most heaviest rains. And a lot of tanks got breached, a lot of people lost their lives. So I request the government to act in time, sir. If they help us at a later date, it will not be much useful, because right now, it's the time for them to help us out. And I also make a request to the government regarding Vishakapatnam steel plant. So through yourself, I request the government not to privatize Vishakapatnam steel plant, sir, because it is a very good asset. We know there are losses, but it has a huge land bank, and provided we give them a captive iron ore mine, sir. It is not a loss for the government to give captive iron ore mines to Vishakapatnam steel plant, because when we auction iron ore mines, there is an element of profit for the contractor, and there's percentage to the government, sir. But when the government allots to Vishakapatnam steel plant, the complete profit is transferred to the government subsidiary. Vishakapatnam is, of course, a government asset. And the valuation of the asset also will go up. We can actually restructure all the finance. You can do a very good financial restructuring. And I think it will be a very profitable asset, sir. So we request the government to reconsider and not to privatize. Our party demands that the Vishakapatnam steel plant is not privatized, and the government should run the Vishakapatnam steel plant, sir. And I will also like to bring to the notice of the government that post-bifurcation, we don't have tier 1 cities, sir. We have all medium-sized cities. So we are not getting enough investments in the medical sector. We suffered in COVID, sir. Our patients had to go to Hyderabad or Bangalore or Chennai for better treatment. We had very few hospitals. So our Honorable Chief Minister has come up with 13 new medical colleges and hospitals, because there is no other option. When private investment is not coming, the government has to step in and do. So even the Honorable Prime Minister has announced that the Government of India will sanction one new government medical college for every uncovered district. So I request, through yourself, I request the Honorable Minister and the government, sir, so to help us out in the construction of these medical colleges. And I would also like to bring to the notice of the Minister that she has that cryptocurrency, whatever regulation is being done. I'd also like to understand what is the what regulation or what is the government doing to regulate this non-fungible tokens, because it also needs to be regulated. And in the end, sir, I request the government, sir, to increase our MP lads, because MP lads are most effectively used when we go into the constituency. We can help people then and there. We don't need, we cut down the red tape. So the amount we increase is directly going to go into the, going to help the public, sir. So through yourself, I request the Honorable Finance Minister to consider increasing MP lads. And in the end, I request the Honorable Finance Minister, and I request the government, I request even the Prime Minister to be sympathetic towards Andhra Pradesh. Please help us out. We have suffered enough, and the tenure of the AP Reorganization Act is just 2 more years. So kindly help us out. Thank you, sir.